Hi guys, it's Simlesy here, so welcome to another speed build. So today I am building something that I have never built before and that I kind of thought I would probably never build because if you guys have been keeping up with my builds for my save file, and especially here in Windenburg, I have really struggled with what I wanted to do with these specialty lots. And actually recently I built the Von Haunt Estate. If you guys did miss it, I highly recommend that you check it out because that's one of my most favorite builds I have ever done. It's really cool in my opinion, so I think you guys would like it. But anyways, there are other specialty lots here in Windenburg. There's not only the Von Haunt Estate, but there are these ruins. There's also some other type of ruins. I forget what they're called at the moment, but there's like this swimming pool. Yeah, I don't know. I forget exactly what it's called, but yeah, I've been very stuck on exactly what I wanted to do in these neighborhoods, and I honestly went into this build thinking that I wasn't going to record it. I was just going to maybe add a few items here and there to make it a bit more interesting, or just some other activities or something. And then I got here and realized there was literally nothing on this lot. And I was like, okay, well, I should probably do something with this and make this area just more usable. Because honestly, the only time I've ever been here is when my Sim has been invited to a party. But you know, the parties aren't always happening, and maybe you have some teenagers or some, I don't know, other type of Sims that want to come here and get away from, I don't know, I was thinking teenagers, so I'm thinking they want to get away from their parents, they want to just kind of party, hang out with their friends, maybe do some graffiti. And so I went through Pinterest and tried to gather a bunch of ideas, and I came across some really cute pictures of these more miniature castles, and I was like, oh, I could build like a really small castle, because this is a very, very small lot, and it's like 20 by 30, I think. I mean, which isn't like, it's not ridiculously small. Maybe it's actually smaller than that. You know, I don't know how big this lot is. Either way, I think it's about a 20 by 30 lot. And I was like, I can't build something huge here, but surrounding the area, there's a bunch of ruins and they look like castle ruins. And so I thought it'd be fun to build an old part of the castle that still remains, and I tried to make it look as ruiny as I possibly could. I wanted it to look like it was falling apart, which is great because now we do have the live edit objects and you can actually really make this effect look more realistic. I mean, it doesn't look totally ruined. It still kind of looks put together, but I tried my best to add like cracks and different sort of worn out pieces and all of these different little extra bits of castle that are kind of falling apart. So hopefully you guys see what I was going for and get the effect. But yeah, I just came across these really cute pictures of some smaller castles, and I thought it'd be fun to build one in The Sims, and this is what I came up with. So I hope you guys will like it. I think this build is really fun. I had fun playtesting it. I only playtested it with one Sim, so I think it would be a lot more enjoyable with like a group of Sims, and they could just hang out here. And basically, I wanted them to have a place to party and hang out. It's more of like a teen hangout is what I was picturing, and I just filled it with a bunch of different activities. There's a DJ booth in here, and now I did have my Sim try to hire a DJ to come and play, because for whatever reason, she couldn't actually play on the DJ booth, and my Sim does have some DJ skills, so I don't think that was the issue. But maybe if you have a Sim bring a DJ booth in their inventory with them and then you set it up, then they could play it and practice here. I don't know exactly what the best way would be, but I'm going to leave the DJ booth that I placed in here for my upload to the gallery. So if you guys need to edit it, I would probably just think remove that one and have your Sim bring their own. Because yeah, I couldn't get my Sim to hire a DJ to come here and play, so I'm not exactly sure what the issue is. Maybe if I would have had some friends that weren't in my household come along with me, maybe they would have interacted with it. I don't know, but there's some guitars here. There's a dartboard. There's different stereos. There's some coolers so they could have some snacks and stuff. I didn't add any like real appliances, so there's no bathroom here. There's no kitchen because, I mean, this is supposed to be an old castle and I figured nothing remains here, and it probably wouldn't have had like a real bathroom or kitchen because there's probably no plumbing, no electricity, anything like that. So I tried to leave it pretty bare bones, but I wanted to add a few places for your Sims to eat. So there's some coolers, and also there is a place for your Sims to hang out when they're invited to a party on this or in this area. The ruins next to this lot that you'll see as I'm building There's like this whole party area that spawns with, I think there's a bar, there's a DJ booth, and there's this whole party area, but there's, yeah, so there's a bar there, so you can eat there if there's a party, and then also there's some, I think, what do you call those, woohoo bushes, that you can fertilize, so you can use that as the bathroom, but yeah, I think it all totally works, but yeah, I just had a lot of fun with this build, adding all these extra different decorations, and trying to find just things through the live edit objects that make it look Is ruiny even a word? It's probably not, but that's the best word I can think of at the moment to describe it. I wanted it to look as if it was falling apart. And I also thought about adding some tints. You'll see me when I go to decorate it. I'll try to add a tint on the interior, but it didn't really fit anywhere and it just took up too much space. I mean, I could have made it work and it probably would have been usable, but I wanted to add other activities instead. So what I think I would do if I wanted a Sim to stay here was probably bring a tent along with them in their inventory and then they could camp out here and kind of hang out with their friends. I think that would be a fun way to play with some like teenage Sims or some more like younger adult Sims that maybe still live with their parents or like to come here and hang out for whatever reason. I think it would be a lot of fun, but here you can see I'm just going through and adding different plants around. I tried to make it look messy and overgrown. I added a lot of greenery, kind of cascading around the castle, and this wasn't something that I planned on doing, but I noticed in some of the ruins around this area, there were some of those same greeneries, and so that worked out really perfectly because I feel like it makes it blend into the environment a little bit better, and that is something I always really like doing. And I did try sizing up some of the ivy from, I think it was Vampires, but I didn't like it the way it looked exactly. I mean, I did like it because I feel like it looks more natural and realistic, but when I sized it up, it didn't quite look right. And when it's too small, it looks kind of flat in my opinion. I really wish that we had a green version of the ivy, or I know it's not ivy, but there's a different word for it, but the plants that came with Jungle Adventure, the pink and purple and red flowers that you can put growing up your walls, I wish that would have came in a green version. I've seen a CC version that I would love to download, but of course this is for my save file and it's not a CC showcase type build, so I'm not going to use any CC, but that is something I wish would have came from The Sims, because that ivy is my favorite. I'm gonna call it ivy. I know that's not what it's called. I think it's bougainvillea, something like that. But either way, I wish it would have came in a green because I love the colors, but the colors aren't always appropriate for every build. So yeah, I didn't use it here. I decided to use the ivy that came with Get Together. Now, unfortunately, it won't change with the seasons. For whatever reason, all of the wall decorations that are actually, no, the one from Jungle Adventure does change with the seasons. I don't think this ivy changes. I mean, maybe it's just not supposed to. I don't know. But none of the flower boxes do. It always drives me crazy. But either way, you will see on the exterior, I did add some graffiti. I wanted this place to look a little bit more kind of trashed. I mean, I was trying to not go too overboard with the graffiti. I wanted it to still look kind of nice in some way, and I thought it definitely added some character. And then I'd add stairs all the way up to, I think, every level of the tower except for the very top that's outside, so your Sims can go to the different levels and there's different things to do on each of them. I think the very top one is pretty small, so there's not really a whole lot going on there, but I think it looks really good. I tried configuring the stairs in a few different ways, but this was the best way that I found. I get a lot of comments when I place stairs if I don't stack them a certain way or if they're not placed exactly how somebody thinks they should be placed. I do try a lot of different options, I guess, and yeah, usually I place them a certain way because I like the way they look or just functions better that way. I don't know if it's that necessary to comment on that. I've just received a lot of comments regarding when I use stairs, but I usually don't like it when I delete the walls underneath of them, but I felt like for a castle this worked because when I've been to castles in the past, it seems like a lot of them are open underneath, so I felt like it made sense for this build, and I think it works because it also gives you more space, so I was able to put like a place to sit down underneath the stairs and some decoration, like I have some boxes and stuff. I'm not exactly sure what would be in those boxes, but I felt like it kind of added extra decoration without adding furniture, because I really don't feel like there would be a lot of furniture here, because I feel like whatever's in this castle is whatever the teenagers that hang out here have brought here. And so boxes, maybe they've brought along music equipment with them, or boxes of spray paint for their graffiti, or I have no idea, honestly, but I think it looks good anyways. And yeah, I just had a lot of fun adding those extra decorations. I also added some of the ruin pieces that are along the edges of the building. Some of those are actual seats, and I didn't realize it when I was placing it, but when I play tested it, my Sim was really exhausted and needed to take a nap, and she went over and laid on one, and her head was like clipping through the wall, so I did fix that, and I went around and placed a few more seats. So on some of the ruined pieces, your Sims can actually sit down or set things on them or lay down and nap or, you know, whatever they want to do. So I thought that was pretty cool because I didn't honestly even think about it or read the descriptions of them when I was placing them, but I think it's pretty obvious which ones they are. So I think I got all of them, and any of them that you can't sit on is probably blocked on purpose. So yeah, hopefully that's okay. But yeah, I really liked adding all of those extra pieces along the floor. It doesn't look perfect, but I felt like it definitely added to the ruin effect that I wanted this build to have. And I also added a few dance floors in here. So you'll notice that those are the cardboard floor pieces. I placed, I think, maybe three of them in the build, but I didn't want to add like a proper dance floor because I felt like that would be too fancy for the build. But cardboard, I thought, worked really nicely and it looked perfect in my opinion. I do also add a bubble blower later on. That wasn't something I thought about initially, but as I was like building this and trying to find different decorations to place around, I was like, oh yeah, the bubble blower would be perfect. I definitely think some sort of bubble blower kind of hookah type thing would be definitely something you might see in a teen hangout like this. And then yeah, oh, I also add the dartboard. I do have to move it, so it will be in a different location in the screenshots. You guys will probably notice that. It's not too big of a change. It's still in the same area, but my Sim could not use it. I was kind of confused on why she wasn't able to get to it, but either way, I moved it and it works perfectly. And then other than that, I do hang up some like cobwebs because I did want it to feel a little bit dirty, and then also a ton of lanterns because I didn't want it to be completely dark, but I didn't think that there would be electricity here, and I didn't think that there would be any like chandeliers. I mean, maybe I could have put chandeliers with the candles or different wall-mounted candle holders. That might have made sense, but either way, I felt like bringing along lanterns made more sense that way. And I really wanted to add a basketball hoop. You'll see me try to place it a few different times, but yeah, I just couldn't find a great spot to put it. I thought it would be funny if maybe a Sim brought along a basketball hoop, but I feel like that would be probably a lot of effort. So maybe it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. So yeah, I just decided not to place it. Oh, but another thing I wanted to mention was the windows. I decided to go with the windows from Jungle Adventure because they're open and I didn't think glass made a whole lot of sense, but I did use some different pieces from Jungle Adventure to try to make them look like they blended into the castle more, so hopefully that looks okay. I wasn't exactly sure about it, but I think it's pretty cool. But here you can see I'm adding that bubble blower that I mentioned. I do end up moving it to a different room, and then I add a couple of these folding chairs just to have places for your Sims to sit down. And then I do also add some radios and then that DJ booth like I mentioned earlier. And then something I did forget about, I add that, it's, I'm not sure exactly what to call it, but it's that outline that we got from City Living where you can actually spray paint on it. I added it on the floor because I really didn't have any wall space to add the wall one. I really wish I would have been able to, because I think that would have been perfect, but the floor one works, so I just place it down by the entryway of the castle. And then over here is the DJ booth, so my Sim could get behind it, but like I said, she couldn't use it, and when I hired a DJ, nobody showed up, so I'm not exactly sure what the problem is, but you can put these type of DJ booths in your Sim's inventory, so maybe if you have a Sim that's into DJing, you could just put one of those in their inventory and they could come here and practice and perform for their friends for different parties and stuff. If not, if you want to delete it, there's tons of other things to do here, so I don't think it's that big of a deal. So yeah, hopefully you guys have enjoyed this build. I'm just adding the final few details and then we're going to be on to the screenshot. So thank you so much for watching, and please leave any comments or suggestions that you have, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye!
holding on, I wanna let you go. Cause every time I try, you find a loophole. I've been slamming the door and just leave you cold. When I come back, you feed it up the South Pole. You see my body rush for the escape, while my heart wants to stay. Push your